南加地区过去一段时间的气温较低，不过这几天气温回升到了夏日的水平。医师提醒，如果运动量较大或当气温较高时，就要比平常摄取更多的水分，尤其是家长更应该随时的注意孩子的身体状况，避免儿童中暑。
夏天日照时间较长，儿童在户外活动机会更多，但也常常因为忘记适时补充足够水分，或晒过头太阳而出现中暑症状。医师提醒家长，如果发现儿童反应异常，要立即提高警觉。Older
patients can complain of headaches, and then you start to get systemic symptoms like sweating, vomiting. And then as it progresses, you can even see signs like seizure activity or convulsions, and then leading to unresponsiveness. And in tragic, unfortunate cases, rarely those cases can result in death.
一旦出现中暑症状，除了立刻通报911，同时也可以采取一些帮助儿童散热的措施。
Ice bags to the neck, under the arms, armpits, and the groin, so the upper thighs. Those are the three areas that, when exposed to very cold, will immediately drop the body temperature, and that's important. Spray bottles, like mist on a child, will also help. At home, if a child's overheated, you can use fans to draw in cool air, and take towels, put them under very cold water, and literally lay them across the child's body.
其实预防永远胜于治疗，要避免儿童中暑，医师建议
make sure sunblock is put on, and that should be replaced every 1 to 2 hours if your child's going to be in the sun. To always make sure during summer or hot conditions that your child is given adequate fluids, but during hot weather, children in general should drink about twice as much as they normally would during non-heat conditions. And then, of course, making sure that you always take care of your kids by putting them in cool, air-conditioned environment.
另外，有些家长担心婴儿着凉，即使夏天也会将婴儿用衣物层层包裹。对此，医师警告：
Always dress kids appropriately for hot conditions. Think about what you would want as a parent and do the same thing for your child. So if you're wearing a short sleeve shirt, put your child in a short sleeve shirt.
家长可以上网到洛杉矶儿童医院下载预防儿童中暑的相关注意事项，帮助儿童度过健康的夏天。